Lockheed Martin unveiled a new model of the Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer at the 2025 Surface Navy Association, or SNA, conference in Crystal City. The design features additional vertical launch cells specifically configured for AGM-179 JAGM missiles, enabling the ship to carry up to 24 reloadable missiles for counter-UAS operations and naval fire support. Revealed publicly for the first time at SNA 2025, the model showcases two banks of vertical launch cells, each containing 12 missiles, positioned forward of the 64-cell Mark 41 Vertical Launch System, or VLS, module. Expanding missile capacity on existing surface combatants is a top priority for the U.S. Navy. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes Arleigh Burke's potentially getting AGM-179 JAGM. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. American forces in the Red Sea and Gulf of Aden have been shooting down Houthi one-way attack drones and missiles fired from Yemen. The cost of those interceptions was too high. According to the Pentagon's chief of weapons procurement, efforts to take out uncrewed aerial systems were exceeding $100,000 per shot. William LaPlante, the former Undersecretary of Defense for Acquisition and Sustainment at the Department of Defense, noted at a conference hosted by the Center for Strategic and International Studies that efforts to stop drones fired by Houthi militants in Yemen are relying on costly missiles fired from Navy destroyers or fighter jets. He said it's getting too expensive. For example, Standard Missile 2, a medium-range surface-to-air missile, can cost $2.1 million per shot. Also, U.S. warships could run out of missiles, and if the conflict is in a remote area like the Western Pacific, it would be a major problem. Lockheed Martin spokesperson, in a statement to Naval News, said JAGM Vertical Launch, VL, employed from the JAGM Quad Launcher, JQL, is being pursued in order to provide the U.S. Navy and select international partners with an affordable, multi-domain capability. JAGM VL is compatible with all Arleigh Burke DDG configurations and is not intended to replace or displace Harpoon. JQL can be mounted in various locations on all Arleigh Burke DDGs. The Joint Air-to-Ground Missile JAGM program is a follow-on from the unsuccessful AGM-169 Joint Common Missile JCM program, which was canceled due to budget cuts. JAGM will share basically the same objectives and technologies as the JCM, but will be developed over a longer timescale. The JAGM has the same form factor as the Hellfire missile, which it replaces, and is produced on the same production line. The primary increase in capability over the Hellfire is the dual-mode seeker, which incorporates both laser designation and millimeter wave radar for target acquisition. The Hellfire missile had these seekers in separate missile variants. As per Lockheed Martin, this multi-mode missile offers enhanced performance against moving and stationary armor, air defense units, patrol craft, artillery, transporter erector launchers, radar sites, and C2 nodes, in addition to bunkers and other structures in urban and complex terrain. Proven throughout multiple flight tests, the weapon's multi-mode seeker provides an improved semi-active laser, or SAIL, sensor for precision strike, and a fire-and-forget millimeter wave, MMW, radar for moving targets in all weather conditions. the missile sensors are integrated into the JAGM guidance section, which is then mated with the AGM-114R multi-purpose Hellfire II missile body, capitalizing on missile program improvements that have migrated into the modern Hellfire II design. The AGM-179 JAGM has strike envelope of 0.3 to 4.9 plus miles, or a half to more than 8 kilometers. The U.S. Department of Defense plans to purchase 26,319 joint air-to-ground missiles in total, with the production line currently sized to build 1,200 per year. More than 10% of the total planned buy has been procured during the low-rate initial production, or LRIP, phase. Lockheed Martin's self-funded upgrade to the JAGM, the JAGM Medium Range, has been designed for vertical launch from the JAGM Quad Launcher, JQL, with deployment on ships like the LCS in mind. In addition to doubling the range of the JAGM from 8 to 16 kilometers, or 10 miles, the JAGM-MR also contains a third seeker mode, a near-infrared, or NIR, seeker. Lockheed Martin has also developed the JAGM-F, a variant of the JAGM for use by fixed-wing aircraft. Tests have been carried out on the F-15 Eagle and the FA-18 Super Hornet. Red Sea engagements were not the only scenario where cost escalation and magazine size were in focus. This aspect reared its head when U.S. forces joined Israel and other partners in helping shoot down approximately 300 one-way attack UAVs and missiles fired from Iran and its partners toward Israel. On that occasion, several F-15E fighter jets, firing air-to-air missiles, Patriot air defense batteries, and Aegis combat system-equipped warships worked in tandem with Israeli systems like Arrow, David Sling, and Iron Dome to thwart the onslaught, but that came at a very high price. AGM-179 JAGM will not only be much more cost-effective, but two sets of 12 will also add a lot of firepower when it comes to taking out uncrewed aerial systems, or UAS. The proliferation of cheap drones has changed the dynamics of the modern battlefield. Given that Ticonderoga-class cruisers are getting decommissioned, mostly by this decade, and Arleigh Burke taking the center stage, it's paramount that every possible capability-enhancing options are explored. It'll be interesting to see how this pans out.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.